Okay. Well, good afternoon, Susan. It is so nice to have a little bit of time to chat with you today. Thank you so much and for joining me for our interview with Burning Soul Press.
Delighted to be here with you, Julie. Thank you.
Very good. Well, I'll just kick us off today and I'll just introduce myself to you and any of our viewers who are watching this afternoon. My name is Julie Navickas and I am the Impact Manager with Burning Soul Press. And I am joined today by Dr. Susan Maples, who has a very exciting new book coming out in the year of 2022. So welcome, Susan. I'm so excited to be able to chat with you.
Thank you. I'm excited as well.
Yeah. Do you want to start the conversation? Maybe just introduce who you are and kind of what led you on this path to author another book.
I am a 36-year practicing dentist, and I grew up a chronically ill child. My parents were loving, but in an unhealthy household, and I was had a number of hospitalizations under the age of 12, seven of them. Oh. And I overcame a lot of illness through the help of one physician who partnered with me in particular. And I've always known that I wanted to make a big impact with children. I've really dedicated my career toward total health. Mm-hmm. And on my watch, we've had a huge downward health trajectory in the human race and non-communicable diseases, lifestyle-related preventable disease. And watching it has been tragic. So I've known for a long time that we could turn this trend upward if we were willing to partner with children. And while I've partnered with parents to help children, I've learned a lot about brave parenting. And so this is my gift to help parents really raise kids that are happy, healthy, fulfilled, feeling confident, good about themselves, and able to become their best.
Wow, that's incredible. And I really love that, you know, you're pulling this from a place of personal experience too. Tell us a little bit, you know, like what's going to be the main themes that you might find in Brave Parent? What's kind of the content? What's the meat?
So the real deal is these days, everything needs to be evidence-based. Sure. So I will tell you that it's research-based, but hopefully mixed in with so much humor and love and stories. I'm writing it at a time when my son's just about to turn 28 and he's, and my nieces and nephews, and they're gifting me with the ability to tell their stories too. So it's personal and fun. Cool. But in this, there are several sections A to Z on health. The only thing I avoided almost exclusively is sexual health and financial health. I've included a section on eat, which is not only what to eat, but relationships to food. A section on drink, which is A to Z on how do we understand what we're drinking these days. One on digest, which is microbial health, which is a huge issue right now. Oh, wow. Everything from C-sections and allergies and autoimmune diseases and antibiotics to vaccinations. And then we go to, let's see, eat, drink, digest, and then breathe, which is the whole building a bigger tongue box to avoid sleep apnea and sleep-related breathing disorders, how to really get people to nose breathe rather than mouth breathe, and yeah, what are the ramifications of that, tonsils, adenoid removal. Then we go to sleep hygiene and sleep-related breathing disorders for kids, and then social, emotional, and cognitive health, everything from anxiety and depression to addiction and bullying and stress reactions and how to build healthy relationships with other kids and all of that arena. And then one of my personal favorites, of course, is oral health, which is chew and smile, and has the four major oral diseases, including HPV, oral pharyngeal cancer. There we touch on sexual health and body part sex and trying to have kids understand all the ramifications of that. And caries, which is our number one disease on the planet, tooth decay. A lot about 100% preventable disease. How do we do that?
Wow.
And on and on. And then we finished with movement, which is exercise science, everything from cardio versus weights and how to build in healthful living every day to get kids to move and enjoy it and build habits around it. So.
Wow. Okay. So when you say total health, you mean quite literally total health.
Yes. It's been years of writing, but it's a book really focused on that. And really, we need all of it, because all of it are, they're all, everything in the book is contemporary issues. They're not issues that were even 20 years ago.
Oh, right. Right. So, well, it's so nice to hear too. You know, there's so much new research, new literature, and all this new stuff that gets published so consistently. And we live in such a world where all of this stuff, right, comes at us through the media. It's hard to know what to believe or what to even pick up. Yeah.
Anything COVID showed us, it's science illiteracy in our country. It's like, where are we getting our information and how do we do it?
Yeah.
So one of the things that I'm real clear about is I get people's reactions to it. For instance, the physician who helped me organize the citations for the research.
Yeah.
As a young physician, and she said, I've never done this before, because she graduated in research and undergrad, and she does this for a living. And she said, I've never done this before, but as I finished each chapter, I just stopped and reread it for me. She said, you know, I feel like I've been parenting myself. I don't even have children.
Yeah.
And I also didn't grow up in a healthy household. I can't tell you how much this book has changed my life. So it's really going to help the parents, not just the kids.
Wow. Okay. Cause that was going to be my next question, right? Was who do you want to pick up a copy of this book, right? It's called Brave Parent, but it sounds to me as though much of the content is totally transferable. Like I could read that as a parent, but I could also read it for myself.
Anyone who has influence with kids. So teachers, physicians, dentists for sure, but parents and grandparents alike, babysitters, wow. All that. Yeah. And anyone who missed the memo in their own household, where they feel like, why am I stuck? Why am I feeling depressed, medicated, overweight, tired all the time, brain fog? What am I missing? All those answers are in this book.
Wow, that's incredible. So I'm so curious, Susan, you know, obviously you have an accomplished career as a dentist. How do you find the time to come up with all of this amazing literature and then sit down and write it? Like, how long has this been a work in progress?
Well, years, actually. Ever since I finished Blabbermouth several years ago, I offloaded all the kids stuff. That was an oral health book. This was much more. I knew I wanted it to be more. It's really interesting talking to Lauren, who's your founder, I guess. She was my book designer. And I went at this relatively modestly. And as she was reading it, she said, I kept reading sections to my husband. She says, I'm addicted to this book. And she said, this is the book I wish I'd had when I was pregnant.
Yes.
Seriously. And I thought, you know, that's exactly what we want. We want parents who are willing to influence their own lives to become healthier parents, set better examples. There's so much these days that we feel guilty about, not enough. There's so many things to do to be a good parent. And yet sometimes we're doing just the wrong things. We're trying to buy the right things and do the right things and run kids, you know, all over town and make sure they're going to all the things that they need to. And we have to just stop and refocus on what the research tells us about what creates health, mentally, physically, spiritually, emotionally, all the way through.
So. Wow. And I love that too, you know, because you do search, especially as a new parent, right? You have no idea what you're doing. I'll speak for myself. I had no idea what I was doing, right? But to have a resource like this, I mean, how incredible and how powerful to be able to prepare yourself and know what to do and what not to do, right? That's all I feel like parenting is just kind of, you make a mistake and try to bounce back from it.
I know. My sister-in-law kept a little log of all the reasons that her kid might need to go to a psychiatrist. And so when he got there, he could just pull out the book. We had to laugh about that. But we do make mistakes and we're human. And we're forgivable to ourselves and to others, but we have to recognize that we could, if we're brave enough to raise our kids distinctly differently than the next door neighbor, we might actually start a movement in our own neighborhood, because kids really do want to be healthy. Every one of us wants to be healthy.
Yeah,
we do. We're wired that way. But we just need to have some tools and some answers. And this gives really tangible tools to make that happen.
Oh, that's fantastic. You know, and it's one thing to read something and go, oh yeah, well, that's a really good theory or that's a really good idea, but how do I implement it? You know, like what's the takeaway? What's my action item? So Brave Parent is going to offer that.
Yes. I love the word integration. which is really integrating what we know from the research into life. And you are absolutely right. I tried to make this really easy for people to find solutions and you know, what to do.
Things to try and things to work with. Yep. Oh, that's fantastic, Susan. You know, when you picture the impact of this book, you know, what do you envision? What do you want Brave Parent to do?
Well, sadly, my entire career, I've watched the downward health trajectory of the human race, and that's been very sad to watch. COVID hasn't helped. As we know, most people are not healthier, happier, and more stable in any way than they were 3 years ago. No. So what I'm really hoping is the impact will help people get back on track and know exactly what they need to do and be able to do it with some confidence in terms of, you know, organizing their, not just their household, maybe it's their classroom, maybe it's their patients, maybe it's their grandchildren, being able to make learning fun and help kids learn how to become age 18 and have skills, beliefs, and behaviors for a lifetime of health. That's the impact. Sending kids off at that emancipation age, feeling happy, healthy, and confident to go out and take on the world and know that they're going to carry that through.
Wow. See, that is just so powerful to me, because one thing I don't think I've shared with you, Susan. So outside of my role with Burning Soul Press, I work at Illinois State University. So I work with college age students. They're 18, 19, 20, 21. It's eye-opening to see this new generation come in, and things have changed, right? Even since I was that age, it's incredible to see. And I don't want to call it deficiencies, right?
How old are you?
I'm 35.
Mm-hmm. You look young. Last week, I did a lip and tongue release for a little 7-day-old baby. Oh. I did another one today, but I mean, I do them all the time to help latch, to create a bigger, all of that, right?
Yeah.
And this young couple were in their late 20s, and they said to me, I think the mom was 26, and she said to me, it's scary raising a baby now because it's so different from when we grew up. Now, it's one thing for me to say that, but for someone in their 20s, and that is true. That is true.
It is.
So much in such a short period of time.
Oh my gosh.
It's a very scary place for us to be raising kids right now.
Yeah. Yeah. I wholeheartedly support that statement. It's hard to be a parent to begin with, right? And then you try to do it in a pandemic, and we need more resources like Brave Parent. That's the truth.
Yeah. And a school shooting 45 minutes from me.
Michigan. Yeah. 45 minutes from you.
Yeah. Very sad indeed. And you know, these are things that we're finding out we could have identified in this child earlier on.
Far earlier.
So again, there's a lot in there on how to really, be aware of what your child is experiencing, both in terms of social media and in the world. So,
yeah. Oh my gosh. Wow. Well, it sounds like there's an incredible amount of very powerful topics included in Brave Parent. And so I wonder, Susan, you know, can you bubble it down into, you know, what's the core message? What's the core takeaway? If there's one thing that you want a reader to walk away with after having read your book, what is it?
Just a sense of confidence that they have the Holy Grail. They know what they need to do. And all they need to do is brave it out and be courageous and decide, instead of being the mean mom or the mean dad, to say like, I'm the brave one. I'm going to help you live the best life you can, and not back down from that, and just be able to be confident about it.
You can't tell, but I got goosebumps from that one. That's incredible, Susan. Well, I cannot wait to read it. I've heard so many positive things about it from the entire Burning Soul Press team, and I cannot wait to see this when it gets launched in early of 2022. So Susan, with that, is there anything that we didn't touch on today that you feel like you would want readers to be aware of as your book prepares to be launched?
A million things. You know, every chapter could be a book in itself. So we'll have we'll have another opportunity in the future to come back and,
and
speak more about it. I'm really excited to see what curiosities bubble up around it. Yeah. And that's what I'll be doing next, is just really offering more writing in the areas where people are most curious.
Oh, fantastic. That's so cool to know that there's going to be like a what's next, like what's the follow-up, what else, you know, can I include that's going to be helpful as a companion tool.
The Burning Soul Press people are already saying it should be a cookbook. No, it should be this book. It should be, you know, so
it's could really be all fun. Of those things.
Yeah. I love your company with Purposeful Works.
I love it too. It's a great place to be. Yeah. And everything that we do includes incredible authors like you. So it's thank a good you. Team effort. Well, Susan, thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. And truly congratulations. You have a lot of really cool things coming up here in the short-term future. So
thank you. Great big awesome. Hug to you and to all of you listening.
Yes, you as well. Thanks so much, Susan. Have a good rest of your day.
Thank you. You as well. Bye-bye.
Bye.